in my bank account. Yeah, in my bank account. Yeah, in my bank account.
We Dehnzel boy.
3, 4, 5, 6,
gonna go to my office because it's same break, you back. How about you hit it? Gonna teach Game of Rice later in UPLB. So stay tuned for that.
Nigga, get your kill. Nigga, wanna tweet about me? Nigga, get your kill. Nigga,
God, this shit, nigga, nigga. So yun, eh, kita na po yung windmill doon. Sabi, ano, tara, windmill tayo. Alam ko kasi ang lapit lang. Eh, pagpunta doon. Eh, syempre, eh, aakyat, sobrang taso akit. Pagpunta lang kami doon, sundag po kami, walang pera. Hi! Bieber! What's up guys? With me, my panganay Dehnzel in the office. Because he's helping me out to some of the chores I'm doing at work. So, that's an A+. He's like my OJT. So, he's on the job now. And I'm still working with Game of Rice. Not Game of Thrones. Not Game of Death, but Game of Rice. That's it. That's the game. So we're gonna do this afternoon in UPLB, University of the Philippines Pasman. And let's see how the students will interact with the game.
Bakit B? What's the purpose of that? Acupuncture din yan? Anong purpose niyan? Para sa anong condition ang kailangan i-improve niyang bead na yan? Yan si Kichi, ang magiging future acupuncturist ba ang tawag ng Los Baños. So, magpa-reserve na kayo ng schedule sa kanya. O, binaplug na kita ha. Sa Los Baños, siya ang puntahan nyo.
Why din, ang galing ha.
Mabilis ako nga lang yata yung nagagano sa amin.
We're gonna go to the gym. Today, papawas na ang calories.
Right there.
Ang bagal, so bagal.
Salay.
Yung ganyan, no, oho. Yan din siya.
Ito yung tubo mo.
Ah. Kasi ganun eh, di ba? Kailangan din niya yung hila, no? Yung hila.
Finish! Woo! Another day, another workout. Finish. Work hard, yes. Play hard, yes.
Thank you, ah. Ah, he's the 80 tennis court.
Papa would love that. We stay alive, we can play club here.
So now we have the prize to be given at the students who will win the game today, this afternoon. Red rice for the winning team.
Wow, red rice. Wow! King Toman! Sa Benguet Helon, this is an expensive Benguet Helon Rice Agriculture Cooperative. This is expensive.
Lucky winner gets this at the Game of Rice.
Going to Dr. Barker at the education time check. Almost 3:30, he's gonna get mad because we should be there at 3 o'clock.
Might be panicking.
Hey Randy, that's my assistant, my son.
Hi,
Dehnzel, that's my eldest son. Yeah, so he can bring along the laptop and take a picture of us.
Mel is already calling. Ito, on the way pala, kabipika po ko pala si Dr. Barker sa training center. That's Mel. She's confirming the location. So, we have to ask people around.
How do you like that?
Oh, that's like Mr. Bean, huh? That's famous in UK.
Yeah.
Yes, they're here. So that's why. Yeah, so and you work in Sri Lanka, right?
Yeah, right.
Before. I know, and you're in the water management in Sri Lanka. So you happen to talk to them?
Well, sure. Delegation came through.
Yeah. He's going taking up dentistry. He's planning to.
You know, my dentist makes a lot of money.
Yes, that's going. Why yeah. I'm forcing. No, I'm not forcing. He likes also dentistry.
Dentistry. And then you go to the US and
you're gonna have a mansion if you're a dentist.
I tell you, my teeth are so much less.
But they're still gaining money from you, right?
They're still getting money from you.
Agriculture economics. That where Mel is?
Ito, saan ito eh? Anong pangalan?
Mel Molina po.
Molina, tatanong ko lang dito ha.
Siya si Dr. Barker.
Hello!
Member Cenon. This is Carol.
He's a member of the Cornell University and UP College of Agriculture Extension exchange program. And nature has a very special way of welcoming Dr. Barker when he first arrived in this panel. Because 2 days after he arrived, the Al volcano erupted and spewed ashes all over his body. Dr. Bob Chandler and asked him if he would like to join IRI as an agricultural economist. He took on the offer on the condition that he will be allowed to teach one class per year at UPLB or occasionally School of Economics. Professor Randy Parker to be assisted by the data management specialist, Mr. Denner DeLeon. Okay. Programming?
Yes, of course. Yeah.
There is a prize for the winner of the game.
Yeah.
Okay,
it's my turn.
Okay, so everybody was able to access the game of prize. Can you raise your hand for those who are able to access? Okay, so before we start, we have to group the participants by 4, right? So 1, 2, 3. And then I will distribute the worksheet. We're frequently leader. We on the same page, we have to put the default value for each group. How much does a typical rice farmer gain per hectare? Give me an answer per group. Documentary Buster in the rice business, they call it the rice business. states that the farmer net at $481 per hectare. So that's equivalent to 24,747.45 in cropping season of 4 months. That's the dollar rate for today, 51.55. So the closest was Rule 3. So congratulations, you're getting, but that's not the final answer until you play the game, okay? So let's go to the game of rice. So good afternoon, everybody. Daniel and Leon from the International Rice Research Institute, specialist database management. Research database management at the Social Science Division, or now we call it agriculture policy. It's a decision tool designed to teach the players the nature of the disease faced by rice farmers. And in game of rice, we will play the part of a small farmer in central Luzon, a major rice growing area of the Philippines. We have a profit for that. Of course, yes. A main objective here is to maximize your profit. A big round of applause to Randy. He's been calculating the way for now. He never said it for yet. Every time he arrives in TV, this is the only thing that he really has to push up. There's Randy right there. Process that he worked in TV for a very long time. So, go to the top section of the game. Okay, so the winner for this game is group number 2. Round of applause. Okay, so can you, of course, let me better for the leader on the next experience of the game. Yes, we have a prize, but we have to make them deliver first their report. But why they have this value? So don't worry, the typical rice farmer in the Philippines, ganyan talaga. Kaya even if you go to a negative number talaga.
A few amounts of urea, about 2 kg per hectare. And we try our best to minimize our cost. So the yield also increases. So, ito po kami yung murang tas, kung ito nga ka. Okay.
Very wrong po ni Ben. Tapos po parang yung nagawin lang po namin sa sabay. Okay, hindi po, alam mo yung aking yung ano, lagi po may nakalagay sa tayo po.
Okay, okay.
So,
mga wala po kami, pinag-low comment na ang effective na rin sa karabi na rin. Tapos, hand-based po yung business namin.
So, palakpakan everybody. Actually, we will try to improve the game. Kasi napansin nga namin, once na stop kayo sa big typhoon, all the time sa typhoon. So, yung minedyo ko kanina, mag-restart, refresh kayo ng page, pakasakali ng bago dito. Pero ito yung reward namin yung video programmer.
$5? Uy, malaki na yun, ha?
This one is 86. That's group 6, the two ladies over there. Wow, congratulations! 87 years old. Actually, you said it first, 87, diba? Okay, so thank you everybody for attending this rice game course.
Okay, thank you for coming, and we would like to thank the crop farmer for giving us a chance to take part on his work. And we hope to have another round of role-playing game in the near future. Can we have another round, Dr. Barker, the next SEM or...
Oh, Dr. Barker, next SEM.
Nasa yung camera niya.
Yeah,
yeah, right. Okay. Yeah, it's amazing.
Randy can still do it. Now live in the agri, econ building.